spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York.
A pose in your ear is kind of tinnish your ears. Let everybody cringe when you cruise.
I'm Mary Ann Stahl and I'm 80 years old. I'm the dance teacher and I'm the choreographer for the Season Steppers.
This is a lineup of girls.
We're the entertainers.
Okay, you babes of jazz, let's pick up the pace. Let's make the parties longer, let's make the skirts shorter. Let's all go to hell in a fast car and keep it hot.
Corliss Whitney, the former Rockette, was teaching at the time. And Marlene says, you could do whatever you want to do, teach any routines. And I'm thinking, but Corliss is here, you know, I can't go. But I started doing it. We shared a little bit our time. And then I just loved teaching again.
These are my wonderful dancers, and I love them so much.
I'm Carol D'Amato. I'm 68 years young.
My name is Linda Capezza Faisala, and I am 68 years old.
My name is CJ Marie, and I am 70 years old.
Donna Graziano, age 71.
I'm Phyllis Bogart, I'm 75 years old.
Carol Giorgio, I'm 76.
I'm Honey Everhart, and I will be 80 in May.
My name is Patricia Pat Tropia, and I'm going to be 81 in April.
I'm Enid Merrin, and I'm 88.
I'm Claire Millman, and I'm looking forward to my 90th birthday in April.
Okay, do it again. Go. The other step in the, this one is touching, 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 stop. Touching, touching. Bring your arms from high to low.
It's my whole life. I loved it since I was young, and I just love teaching. I love dancing and performing, you know, I wouldn't be doing it if I didn't love it. So that's what's important to me, is just enjoying and loving what you do.
I love to dance, and you turn on the music and I'm just, dancing away because I love to dance. But as a trained tap dancer, to just show up and all of these women, Team America Steppers, they have been dancing a long time, so I have a lot of catching up to do.
I always loved to dance, and then when I joined Senior America and heard that they had a tap dancing class, I was like, oh, awesome.
When you get a little older, it's a little harder to remember all of the steps and sequence and all of that. So for me, repetition over and over again, practice, as Marianne says, just go home and practice. And that I do, you know, but I'm active, so I enjoy doing it.
I knew I was a good dancer. See, that I wasn't afraid of. No, that I have rhythm.
Yes, I'm known as the bionic woman. I've actually had 4 hip replacements, a knee replacement. I had a rod down my femur and a couple other major surgeries in there. But I had a couple of my hip replacements while I was a stepper. And 6 weeks later, I was back in my shoes tapping. And the whole time I learned in the beginning, I sat on my bed and I did this because I couldn't actually physically tap. But actually tapping's probably good for me because it keeps me mobile, keeps me exercising, and it's fun.
I've always danced as a youngster to American Bandstand on TV, things like that, but no formal dance. I just danced whenever there was music playing.
The steppers is like going to therapy. It gets you doing something fun with people that are closer to your age instead of just being involved with family. It gives you an out.
I've always danced since a little kid because I grew up in Manhattan with an Irish family, and all we ever did on Friday nights was sing and dance, and I had an aunt who's a year and a half older than me, and my grandmother would have Friday nights was her sisters would sing, and me and my little aunt would do any kind of dancing we could.
When I was 82 years old, I got my first pair of dance shoes. Somebody else said that recently because that's when the calling came. That's when we found out that a dance troupe was being formed.
I was always musical. I write songs. From my early childhood, throughout my life, and I'm still doing this, when something impresses me deeply, or someone, I write a song.
Well, over the years, these are some of the costumes we have now for our dance numbers. These are the hats that go with the outfits, and we'll be wearing 2 of them for the pageant.
It's up to you, New York.
Okay, and then the other one I think we're doing is Someone in the Crowd, a La La Land, and this is the hat that goes with this.
You got the right address, you need some medication, the answer's always yes. A little chance encounter could be the one you've waited for. Just squeeze a bit more, tonight we're on a mission, tonight's the casting call. This is the real audition.
Oh, God, help us all.
You make the right impression, then everybody knows your name. We're in the fast lane. Someone in the crowd could be the one you need to know. The one to finally lift you off the ground. Someone in the crowd could take you where you want to go. If you're the someone ready to be friends, the someone ready to be
needs you to do.
Designed by me and dressmaker would make them up. I'm happy with my whole life, what I'm doing. I had a good life. I always loved dancing. That was my first love.
Follow your passion, you know, and there's so many distractions that could, you know, take you off your path for doing that. You name it, they're all over the place. But if you're able to find your better self and follow through whatever it is that you love to do.
Everybody has bad days, and you're right. But they shouldn't last forever. And if you have a bad day or if something is really that bad, then you need to talk about it. You need to get to the source of it. And motivating, all of you are motivating to me. I mean, youth is motivating. My friends who have, at my age, have problems or something, it's motivating to hear them and to see what I can do, what area I can give of myself to help them get over it. And set their sights on something. sometimes getting out of something that's hard is setting your sight on something else. And when it's your interest, that's motivating, you know, in what you love to do. You know, and it's a lot of, it's a lot of soul searching. And young people, I think that's what we don't have time to do.
One thing that I know, that I'm not in control of anything. Now I want you to hear how that sounds. Not control of anything. I firmly believe in God. And the best advice I got from my early 40s to now was your joy is your job, not anybody else's job. But the real joy comes when you follow God and He tells you what you need to do.
My mom just was always like, you know, treat people kindly, treat people. Sometimes she would say, don't treat them how you want to be treated, treat them how they'd like to be treated. And I just thought that was good because you may want to be treated a lot different than I do. So if I treat you the way you want to be treated, that's good.
Don't try and be someone that someone else wants you to be, because you can only do that for so long, and then the real you comes out eventually. So it's better to be that way in the beginning, and then you don't have to have any pretensions.
I know this sounds silly, but I thank God every day for all that He has given me. My family, my friends, and the opportunity to experience so many things in life that I never even thought existed. And I've been just totally blessed.
I certainly thought if I lived this long, which I didn't think I would, I said, oh, I'm going to be dancing somewhere, somehow. And I like to sing too, so I said, I hope to God I'll be singing and dancing, even if it's in the house or in the car, which I do. Anything, you know, I hope to God I can live to 80. And here I am. I never thought I'd be in a show, though.
If you walk around and you bitch and moan, and you let everything that's in your life get to you. One of the big things, of course, like the pandemic, a lot of people succumbed to it. They really did. We saw how they, well, some actually died from not only the disease, but of loneliness, of despair, of boredom. And we were very lucky. I had a dear friend, Pat, who helped me get through it. And we got through it together. We really did. And you occupy your mind like everything. You don't vegetate. That's how you stay young. I call myself Peter Pan because I don't want to get old.
If you can make it better through some way that you are able to do through your life, if you can better it for others in times to come, that would be nice instead of just living.
I just hope that I can keep doing it and my legs will keep dancing for me, keep in good shape as long as I can do it.
I don't even want this gorgeous gal to leave without a standing ovation.
I think you just got to work hard, put a lot of time and effort into anything you want to do. Besides dancing or any job you have, is really devoting a lot of time and loving. See, I always loved what I did, so loving what you do is, it makes it twice as nice when you really love what you're doing.
I want someone to love me. I need someone who needs me.